Hi guys, my name is Dr. Arohi Maniar and today we are going to discuss about temporization. It is a topic from prosthodontics and basically it is from the chapter of fixed partial denture. So basically, what is temporization? So temporization is nothing but provisional restoration. So when we prepare our tooth and we have to give our patient a temporary crown over it before our permanent crown is fabricated from the lab. So the process of doing that whole temporization or giving the patient our provisional restoration is known as temporization. So basically today we are just discussing about the techniques. You can read about the definition and the advantages and everything from the book. But the techniques are very important and very hard to understand. So I have just simplified it for you guys. So basically in technique of fabrication, we divide it into two parts, that is our direct fabrication and indirect fabrication. So what does this mean? Direct fabrication means we directly put our provisional restoration or our temporary crown, we fabricate the temporary crown inside the patient's mouth. We don't take it to a lab and we don't fabricate in a lab. We do it in the same appointment, we do it on the spot. So in direct restoration, we have two methods according to which we can directly do our temporization. So first is by using our preformed polycarbonate crowns and the second is our custom made with index. So I'll discuss about this in detail and then we'll move forward with our indirect temporization. So in direct, the first one, preformed polycarbonate crown. So how do we use this polycarbonate crowns to get our index? Okay. So first, we measure the occlusal cervical height of the crown and the measured distal width of our crown. So it is the tooth is not yet prepared. The patient has come to you. You have to give, you have to prepare a crown over it. You have to grind the tooth from all the sides. So before doing that, before touching the tooth, first you will take the occlusal cervical height and the measured distal width of the teeth. Okay, after that you will prepare the tooth. Once you have the measurements, only after that prepare the tooth. So once we have the dimensions of our teeth, we'll select the same size and the shade that our teeth are there. So if I have to prepare my left central incisor, first thing when I go to my dentist, what he or she will do, he will take our my measure distal and occlusal cervical dimension, then he'll grind my tooth. And after that, he'll use that polycarbonate crown to produce an index. So this is my polycarbonate crown. Then I prepared my tooth. So the prepared tooth is in black color. Then I select a larger size. Why don't we select the same size of polycarbonate crown? Because we need to put a luting cement in between. So if this is my crown and if I have the same size of the polycarbonate crown, where will my luting material go? We need to have a little bit of space for that. So we'll go for a larger size, but the same shade, okay? So this is the size and the shade we now get of our polycarbonate crown. So we'll select that. We'll pour autopolymerizing acrylic resin into it. And then we'll put the whole unit on our prepared crown. So this is a diagrammatic representation which will help you out to understand what I just said. So this is my polycarbonate crown template. So this is my polycarbonate crown and this is the tab with which I can hold that into place. Then I'll prepare my tooth. So my central incisor will be a little bit smaller than the normal size. After that, I'll use this template and I'll pour autopolymerizing resin into it. So once I fill it with resin, this is my prepared tooth. This is my autopolymerizing resin. And this is the outermost is the tab. So when I cover it with like this and when I remove the polycarbonate crown, I'll have a crown, a temporary crown of autopolymerizing resin over my prepared tooth. So this is one of the methods of direct. This will be directly occurring in the patient's mouth. The next step is with custom made index. So what do we do there? First, we'll take the impression with putty or irreversible hydrocolloid material. So and then we'll prepare the tooth. Similar like what we did here. We did not prepare the tooth before taking the impression. The teeth was intact, the teeth was normal and of natural dimensions. And first we took our impression, then we prepared our tooth. So now the tooth will be smaller in size. And after that, we use that impression as our index. Here we had a tooth, a crown, a polycarbonate crown as our index. Here we'll have our impression as an index. So this is also another diagram. This is my lateral incisors and central incisors. I'm preparing this central incisor, the one which is marked with double dash. So here I prepare, before preparing the tooth, I am taking an impression. This blue line signifies the impression that I am taking. After that, I'll prepare my crown. So here the central incisor is a bit shorter from all the dimensions. And over this, when I have, we already have this impression, right? So I'll fill this impression material with resin, autopolymerizing acrylic resin. And when I press this here, I'll have space around this, so it will take up the space of the central incisor and we'll get our temporary crowns. So these are the two direct methods with which we can do our temporization. Now moving on to the indirect methods. So in indirect methods, we again have two methods. So the first is preformed with nickel chromium crowns. Here we were using polycarbonate crowns, whereas in indirect method, this is going to happen outside the patient's mouth. So here we'll use nickel chromium crowns, and the other is with custom made template. Custom made is, it is very specific to every patient, whereas preformed is not so specific to the, it is a generalized term. So first we'll look for the nickel chromium crowns. So we'll prepare the tooth here. In the direct cases, we were not touching the tooth before taking the impression, but in indirect method, we will prepare the tooth first, then we will take an impression, then we'll make a cast from that impression. So on our cast, we will have our prepared tooth. The tooth will be smaller, the tooth will be grounded. We'll take the measurements and then we'll select our crowns. Like in orthodontic, we select, you know, over the six, our molars, we have to band our molars or we have to put crowns on our molars. So we select it from a tray. There are preformed nickel chromium crowns. Similarly, here also, we also have preformed nickel chromium crowns. We'll select those crowns, we'll try and fit it over the cast. If it fits very nicely, then we'll transfer it to the mouth. So this is an indirect method, because this everything happens, the selection of the crown happens on the cast, it does not happen in the patient's mouth. That is why it is known as indirect method. And lastly, the last one is a bit tricky, but it is very amusing when you understand this. It is a vacuum formed template. So basically it is nothing but when we have a bag of chips and we vacuum it. So the transparent bag will be tightly fitted to all the chips in the bag, right? So similarly, here also, we'll have our diagnostic cast. We will do our artificial teeth arrangement on it, because we will have our prepared tooth, right? Over that, we have to have a proper, our natural dimension of teeth. So we'll need to have our artificial teeth arranged. But here, the one tricky thing is, we cannot arrange these teeth in wax, in our modeling wax, because in vacuum form template, we are going to use thermoforming machine. Thermo itself means heat. So if we have heat during the machine, it is going to dissolve the wax. It is going to melt, not dissolve, it is going to melt the wax. So we cannot arrange the teeth using wax, modeling wax. We have to arrange using putty, and then we put the whole unit, the teeth which are arranged in the putty, we are going to put the whole unit in a thermoforming machine. So what does that thermoforming machine do? So when we have a cast with teeth and we put a transparent sheet of transparent piece like that, and we start the thermoforming machine, it is going to produce vacuum. Because of the vacuum, the sheet is going to sag, the sheet is going to take up the shape of our teeth. So heating will make the sheet sag, and then we have to remove the sheet, adjust. It is nothing, it is but exactly like our retainers. After orthodontic treatments, our dentist might give you a transparent retainer or maybe aligners. The Invisalign, which is very much famous these days. So this is nothing but exactly the same thing that happens in the thermoforming machine. Something like our transparent, template like thing happens, and that is fitted into the patient's mouth. So this is the vacuum form template, and that is all about our temporization. Thank you. I hope you enjoy this video, and if you have any doubts or any questions regarding this topic or any other subject, you can write in the comment section below. Also, let me know any other topics you would want me to discuss on this channel, and don't forget to subscribe and press the like button. I also have an Instagram ID for the same, so you can contact me there. It goes like Arohi_Manyar. I'll put it in the description box below. Thanks for watching.